Hello everyone, my name is Adrian and welcome to another episode of Connect. So today we have Michelle Tate coming back to the show to give a demo to talk a little bit about concurrency and multiband and some of the resources that we have available for developers. So thanks for coming and welcome back.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here again and it's good to see you again. I'm really excited to show you what TI's latest offering is on the CC1352R LaunchPad, which supports multiband concurrency.
Awesome. And when you say multiband, we're talking about multiple protocols, but also multiple frequencies at once.
Yes, exactly. So this specific example is going to go over Bluetooth plus sub-1 GHz concurrently using the Dynamic Multi-Protocol Manager, the DMM.
DMM, awesome. Yeah. And before we jump into the demo, can you maybe walk through like a use case? Like why would I want to run both Bluetooth and sub-gigahertz simultaneously?
Yeah, for sure. So imagine a scenario in which you have a hotel and there's multiple doors everywhere. You have your hotel concierge and then you also have your smartphone as well. Every single door is connected in a sub-1 gigahertz network that reports back to the hotel concierge's node remote display, so say his laptop. And so these doors are sending back data all the time saying, am I open, am I closed, what is the status of my e-lock? And from his remote display, he can open it and say, I should lock this door because it's been unlocked for a long amount of time. And so he can send that command to all doors simultaneously or one door at a time. Awesome. In addition, it's really cool as a user. So if I'm staying at a hotel, I don't have to carry around a plastic key card anymore. I can walk up and use my phone and unlock my door using just my phone saying unlock.
Awesome. So you kind of get the best of both worlds. You get kind of the low power capability and long range of sub-gigahertz and then some of the accessibility benefits of 2.4 or Bluetooth specifically.
Exactly, yeah. And that's why we're so excited about this and why it's a really good, DMM's really good for many end applications of this.
DMM, awesome. Yeah. Well, let's jump straight into the demo. So you've got two launch pads here, and can you maybe walk through what we've got going on?
Yeah, of course. So as I mentioned before, we had a remote display. And so right here on my left, I have my remote display. The remote display is going to be running sub-1 gigahertz plus BLE at the same time.
Okay.
So right here on my right, I have my sub-1 gigahertz sensor. So what's happening here is that we have our sub-1 gigahertz sensor sending back our data to our remote display every 1 second.
Okay, and there's a terminal capability here as well, so we can open
there
that
is.
Up.
So again, on the laptop, you can see on the left, we have our sub-1 gigahertz sensor, and then on the right, or on the left, we have a remote display, and on the right, we have our sub-1 gigahertz sensor.
Okay.
And so our sub-1 gigahertz sensor is sending data over that sub-1 gigahertz link to our remote display, and it continues to do this every 1 second. At the same time, our remote display is sending out Bluetooth BLE advertisements, which my phone can pick up and end up pairing with this remote display in order for me to control the remote display and sensor.
Okay.
So on my phone, I open the BLE scanner app, which is where we're going to be able to sense this Bluetooth advertisement. And here I should be able to find a node remote display service and connect to it. And so, as you can see, when I connected to it right here on my left, node remote display TerraTerm terminal, you can see that advertising is now set to disabled so that we can only have this one connection at this time.
Perfect.
So this is really cool because now that we're connected to the remote display, I can send commands from my phone to the remote display that relays it into my sensor. All the while, the sub-1 gigahertz data continues to transmit, and so nothing's interrupted.
Okay, cool. And this DMM capability, I guess this is a software package that we provide developers so they can, I guess, more focus on their application, and the DMM module more or less take care of the concurrency challenges.
Yes, exactly. And so we've packaged it really nicely. You can go to dev.ti.com in order to use TI Resource Explorer, which contains this entire demo, so that developers can use it, get up and running really quickly, and then use it to develop their solutions on their own.
Love it. Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Michelle. Learned a lot about DMM and concurrency. You can learn more about this solution and the rest of the SimpleLink platform at ti.com/SimpleLink. Be sure to check us out next week, where we'll be bringing in another expert, Ben Gilboa, to talk about our new SimpleLink sub-gigahertz stack that's been integrated into our SimpleLink SDKs. In addition, feel free to follow us and tweet back at us at SensorToCloud. Let us know feedback or any new topic ideas if you want to see some future videos pertaining to particular topics. So thanks again for watching, and thanks to Michelle for hanging out.
Thanks. Happy to be here.
Okay, great. That's cut.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Seemed good to me.
Yeah, solid.
Okay.
Yeah. Good.
Nice.